Good morning, Newman Smith. I'm Dr. Jimenez, the proud principal of Newman Smith High School, where our mission is to graduate all scholars to be college, career, and military ready without remediation. Welcome back, alumni Richard Odior. He comes to us all the way from New York City, and we're so excited to talk to him again. Richard, what's going on in New York City?
Hey, how you guys doing? Richard Odior here. Things are going well. Starting to get a little cold out here, so outdoor dining is kind of coming to an end. And obviously, like everyone else in the country, COVID is picking up again. So trying to take some safe precautions to really just make sure that me and my loved ones are taken care of. Obviously, working daily at Facebook, trying to also get the word spread out of how you can be safe in your communities and how you can keep everyone else safe.
Wow. Richard, even though your senior year, I can imagine, was very different from what our seniors are experiencing now, what would you say translates from that senior year to you in quarantine in New York? Which I know sounds crazy, but Richard, I'm counting on you. What translates?
I think senior year is the year of doubling down. So when I say doubling down, I mean there's some relationships that you will build that will transgress over time, over anything else that will happen in life. And so what I kind of urge people to do is in senior year, check on your friends, be compassionate, become a better friend, figure out how to serve your friends best. I literally last Thursday had a call with four of my friends from high school, and we were on the call for 3 hours on FaceTime. So I know you guys feel separate, but figure out ways to be close, because I will say this, the relationships and the way you learn to build relationships and manage them will actually change the way you operate in life going forward. COVID is tough. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. It's tough for you, it's tough for me. I know you wanna be with your friends, but I would say use this time to figure out how best you can serve your friends. Have you checked on all your friends? Do you know what's going on with them and their families? Make sure you make that call if you've been thinking about someone. I think this is a time to really double down on all the relationships you have, even if you can't be in person.
Wow. Richard, I heard you say that the outdoor dining is going to come to an end in New York, but yet you took advantage and did a FaceTime call with some of your friends. What are some of the plans as, you know, you and you guys in New York City are possibly facing another shutdown? How do you think you'll take advantage of the time that you could be kind of hunkered down again, so to speak?
Yeah. So I think oftentimes we've looked at the pandemic in a lot of ways that's negative, right? And it is. People are dying, people are sick, but I think the things that we have to be focused on is there's little time that we ever get in life to spend with our quality loved ones at home. Spend that time. Have the conversations that you probably need to have. Learn about them in different layers of them. I actually went home for a bit of the pandemic and I spent some time with my parents, which is the longest time I've spent since high school. And it was crazy the things that I unraveled through conversations with them, like understanding my parents as human beings, just not mom and dad, but like understanding the layers of who they are and just spending that quality time. I think although I can't go out, there's a lot of things I can discover inward and a lot of relationships I can discover within my own home. I think also like there's some really crazy shows on TV. So me and my friends are watching them together. We're texting about them, conversating. Obviously we're watching and playing games digitally and everything else. So I think there's a lot of unique ways that you'll actually learn to be close with your friends. Also, this is great practice for college, if I think about it. You and your friends are about to venture out and go all over the world, even if it's not college, if it's the military, if it's technical programs. You guys are gonna separate come next May and travel all over the world. And you're gonna need to figure out how to stay close, even if you're not close. And so this is a good time to really start understanding, how are you guys going to communicate? Is it a Friday night call? Is it a Tuesday night call? Is it a spades game? Is it Uno digitally? What are you guys going to do? But figuring out how those communication levers work within you and your community. Because at least for me, my community was one of the strongholds that kind of helped me elevate over life. And they're still with me to this day. So, yeah.
Awesome. Well, Richard, I think one of the things I love so much about Newman Smith, it's that we produce graduates who go on and do things like you're doing and who find ways to excel even in the hardest of times. You know, I want to ask before we go, can we talk to you again before the holidays? Because you're really one of our only regulars.
I'm definitely down to talk to you guys before the holidays. I'm also down to answer questions about whatever it is people and students are interested in learning more about. I can give you more about my story. I can give you more about what people I know from universities are doing. So I'm always here as a resource, honestly. I do this primarily because people made themselves available to me when I was in school. And so it's kind of this giving back nature, the people who gave to me, the program they gave to me, and just learning and giving back. So I think it's a New Mississippi culture thing, right? You might receive a lot from the community, you might receive a lot from the school, but also giving it back in ways that you can. So just here for you guys. So if there's any questions you have, if there's anything you need, feel free to reach out.
Well, Richard, thank you. One of the things that I'm trying to do as the principal this year is really get our community wrapped around our kids. And you've been a huge part of that. Matter of fact, we had another alumna on the news. My plan is to have some more. But Richard, you're the first. You're our regular. So we look forward to talking to you again over the holidays. And scholars and Newman Smith community, know that we love you. We think you're great. Remember, character counts. And, you know, just like Richard's doing in New York City, make it a great day or not. The choice is really yours, truly yours. All right. Thanks, Richard.